Hello everyone. In this video, we will talk about a JSON parsing using Python. Now, JSON files are widely used in the field of web development. So, if you want to send some data to an API, then we generally send it either in XML or a JSON format. If you want to send some data from client side to server side, we generally prefer XML or a JSON format. So, in field of web development, you will come across this XML or a JSON file formats. Okay. Now, when we talk about XML and a JSON, so these two files are very lightweight file formats, and you will only have data. You will not have any kind of functions in it. That is the reason these are very lightweight and mainly used for your client side and the server side communication. Okay. So, how you can parse JSON files using Python. So for this, I have this sample JSON file. Now first, let's compare the data types in JSON and in Python. Okay. So in JSON, we have something called JSON objects, and it is similar to Python dictionary. That means I will have the key and the value. Then we have numbers, both that is decimal and without decimals. Similar to this, we have integer and a float data structure. We have array to store multiple values, so it can be strings or numbers. In Python, we have this product. We have tuple in Python, but tuple data type is not present in JSON. JSON string should be enclosed in double quotes, but in case of Python, it can be single quotes or in double quotes, or it can be in triple quotes. Okay. So now let's discuss how I can parse this. So I can open this JSON file using normal open function also, and I can parse it. But it will be bit tedious. I need to read it line by line. I need to search for this particular key, and then I need to update the value. Okay. So Python provides one module called JSON. So I'm just writing import. So this module will help me to parse the JSON file in much more easier. Okay, so let's see how I can parse it. So first thing I'm doing, I'm just opening this JSON file using normal open function. So syntax, I'm writing open function, then specify the file name, that is JSON underscore input and the extension. I'm opening this in a read mode. Now currently this file is present in the same directory. So this will return me a reference, let's call it as handle. So now if I read this content, let's say handle.key. Now if I print the content, this will give me the JSON content, but it is in a string format. Okay. So this module, that is JSON module, it will provide me few methods using which I can convert this JSON content into Python dictionary. So how I can do this? So we have function called loads. So you just have to specify this data to that function, and it will convert it to Python compatible format automatically. So I'm writing Python dictionary, let's say call it as D. JSON.loads and pass the content. If I say print d, now I'm getting this JSON data in a dictionary format. So now I can access it using concept of dictionary. That means I can access, if I want a value, then I can access it using d. Okay. So it is an example of nested dictionary. So it is a top level key, and this is the value for it. Inside that I have another key, and this is the value. Again, this is the key, and this is the value for it. Okay. So now if I set the square brackets and specify this particular key, this will fetch me the value. If I want to access this port number, then I can access this like this. So if I want to modify the value, so all I need to do is OK. So I want to modify this particular key, and now let's say set the port number to 3333. Okay. Now let's see our Python dictionary. Okay. Now I said we do not have a tuple data type in JSON. So what I'm trying to do is, for a particular file, let's try to add a tuple. So let's try to modify value for this log. So how I can reach to this log? So it is actually present in this file. So let's go step by step. So this log key is present in this file key. So I'm fetching this data. So d of files. I need value of this log. So now if I execute this, okay, I am able to fetch the data. Let's add two values for this. So I'm copying this, paste it here, and let's assign a tuple. So one value is this, and let's add another value. So I'm adding two values. Now let's check our dictionary. Okay, so I modified it to a tuple. So for now we have done modification in Python dictionary. If I want to write it back in a JSON format, so I can open the file in a write mode and I can write the content into it. So what I'm doing, I am creating a new file for the output. So for that, just let me close this handle first. So I'm writing handle.close. Okay. I'm creating a new file. Let's say open. Let's call it as JSON output dot JSON. And open it in a write mode. So this will give me a reference. Let's call it as again handle. So now the next step is the dictionary which you have converted to the JSON format. So for that we have a function called dumps. So if I write JSON dot dumps and just specify this dictionary, and let's call it as J. So now if I print this J, so it will give me a JSON format for this. And if you see the conversion, so all the strings are in double quotes and we added a tuple, so Python, it will automatically convert it to the array data type of JSON, that is put it into the square brackets. Okay. So this dumps method will automatically do all the conversions. So now all you need to do is just write this content to a file. I'm opening this file in a write mode and let's say just handle.write and just specify this JSON. And I'm closing this handle. I'm saving this. Now let's open our file. Okay, so I will get the JSON file like this. Just check the data. Okay, so it is adding this in an array format, and we change the port number also. So now it is showing up a port number is 3330. I can specify few more values while converting. Let's say here when we see, so it is a bit difficult to read. So I can prettify this using indentation. So if I say indent this with 4 spaces. So now if I execute this and if I go to this file, so it will add 4 spaces and I will get a indented JSON file. If I want to sort it, then I can add another attribute. Let's say sort underscore keys and set a value to So now if I execute this, it will sort your JSON file in alphabetical order. So this is how you can pass your JSON files. So using this, you can create a JSON file and you can read and update the existing JSON files also. So in the next video, we will talk about how we can pass an XML file with a similar approach. Thank you.